Good morning and welcome back. We're live in the kitchen at the KTVO studios with Joe Manhart, also known as the Egg Lady, which means we are going to be doing something with eggs. In this case, we're making hollandaise sauce, which you said you can use on multiple different dishes. When it comes to eggs benedict, you're going to even pour it on some vegetables, and you're going to show us how to make this awesome sauce.
Absolutely. And the typical eggs benedict is thought of as going with, the typical hollandaise is thought of going with eggs benedict. So, pardon my fingers, but I am preparing, in the nick of time, the base for an eggs benedict, which is a toasted English muffin, a piece of ham, and a poached egg. And here is the other recipient for our wonderful hollandaise. Step one. Warm your blender. It's very
so all you did was just put some hot water in there,
Yeah, and that's important. It'll make the process go better. And then put in about a teaspoon of salt, juice from one lemon. Six egg yolks. You knew this was coming. Six egg yolks. And we'll talk about what happens to the whites in just a minute. Sorry about that.
That's
I should have told you to be prepared. Blend that up. And then...
Oh, I can smell the lemon juice.
Great.
And then slowly from the top on a slightly lower speed. Melted butter. Melted butter. One cup, which is two sticks. And this makes a cup and two-thirds. So you might not use it all. It always works.
We need to get you a megaphone so that when you're blending things, we can hear you.
I thought, you know, this is not an easy thing for the TV stations to deal with, I can tell you.
That's okay.
And so as you're slowly doing that, this is getting thicker and thicker.
And as it's warm now, and as it cools, it will get even thicker. That is a very thin hollandaise sauce, but I'm going to make it a little bit thicker. And a little, where is my shaker, of cayenne pepper. Check the top of your cayenne pepper holes before you do this.
Yeah, that's good to know.
Kind of turned it brown one time. This should do it. And you can put it in a beautiful blue pitcher, a small little pitcher or whatever.
And then you just
pour it over. And as I said, it makes one and two-thirds cup, which is quite a bit. Now, as to what you do with hollandaise sauce, you can see that you can put it over broccoli or asparagus, steamed asparagus. But did you think about beets? You didn't think about beets. James Beard, who is my new favorite, bless his little heart, says that there is no thing almost that you can't put hollandaise sauce on it. And you can change it into other sauces by adding spices and rosemaries. And I think those of us here in the heartland don't pay enough attention to sauces.
Yeah, I would agree.
That's why I like to eat out so much.
But this was so easy to make, so.
It is, and what do you do if you have some left over, which I did yesterday? You put it in a Ziploc bag and put it in a cooler, a refrigerator, and then sink your bag in warm water, and every now and then do this. And now we've got perfectly good hollandaise sauce again.
Lovely.
What with the egg whites, put them in a Ziploc bag. I could sell Ziploc bags. I really could. And peanut butter and Tupperware. Those are my,
And eggs.
Oh, not to mention eggs.
It's Friday.
That's the way I am Monday too.
So
just throw it in the freezer. You don't have to add salt or anything to it. And this is ready to go. If you want to make a souffle or even just scrambled eggs and make them lighter, angel food cakes, meringue, frozen egg white actually performs more easily than regular egg white.
Really?
Okay, and this is from my backyard, which is being overcome by chives, and they last a long time. And if you so wish, a little grind of pepper.
Okay. Mm-hmm. It's right over there.
Okay. Well, it's okay. We can mime it. Right, ah, there it is.
Look at that.
And I mean, we eat with our eyes, do we not? Put a little grind of pepper on top of
Perfect.
That.
Perfect. That looks wonderful.
That. So and there you have it.
It looks wonderful. So what we'll do is we're just going to go ahead and come back, and then when we come back, we'll just kind of
reiterate what we did.
Yeah. Sound good?
We got a little confused there. I think we need a little reiteration.
Yes, that's fine. In the end, if you're just joining us, we just made instantly hollandaise sauce, courtesy of Joe Manhart, also known as the Egg Lady. Nice thing about this, easy to make. We only used 5 ingredients, so really quickly, just recap the ingredients that we used.
All right, what we had was salt. And you know, I like to use kosher salt. Mm-hmm. Kosher sauce has more guts to it.
Okay.
And the juice of a lemon, mm-hmm. 6 egg yolks, mm-hmm. a dash of cayenne, mm-hmm. and a cup of melted butter, mm-hmm. which is two sticks.
You also said to warm up your blender
that
beforehand.
Really helps. Sometimes I've had trouble with mayonnaise uh-huh. when I make mayonnaise in the blender, and temperature does count. Eggs are easier to separate when they're cold mm-hmm. because they're cold and they're stiffer, mm-hmm. but they're easier to cook with in baking and everything if they're room temperature.
And you said with the egg whites that you have left over to put it in a bag and then stick it in the freezer, and then when you want to use them for other cooking dishes like souffle cakes and all that stuff.
That's true. And you see these little things floating around in there? That is the chalaza. That's the muscle that holds the yolk in the center of the egg.
Interesting.
So do not worry about it. Don't try to get it out, strain mm-hmm. it out.
That
or
would
anything.
Be me. I would try to get it out.
It's just a little gristle, mm-hmm. only it's not as hard as gristle, but it's a natural component of the egg.
And then what you did with your sauce is you obviously put it on Eggs Benedict, was what you usually would mm-hmm. put hollandaise sauce with. And you also did it with some vegetables that are in season. We have asparagus and broccoli as well. So and very versatile when
somebody
it comes.
Somebody said it should be a law to not serve salmon mm-hmm. without hollandaise sauce.
Oh, interesting. Oh. So what we'll do is, again, this recipe is very easy. We'll post it on our website at ktvo.com. Just click on the Good Morning Heartlands tab at the top of the homepage. Again, thank you so much for joining us this morning, and thank you for stopping
by. You're welcome. You know, it's better if you make it homemade.
Of course, everything's better when you make it homemade.
Yeah, and this is easy.
All right. Easy. Thanks again for watching us this morning. We hope you have a fabulous weekend, and we'll see you right back here Monday morning at 5:30 a.m.